Problem six. Ada the ant starts at a point O on a plane. At the start of each minute, she chooses north, south, east or west and marches 1 meter in that direction. At the end of 2018 minutes, she finds herself back at O. Let N be the number of possible journeys which she could have made. What is the highest power of 10 which divides N?
Okay, so this doesn't look too difficult. All we need to do to make sure that Ada ends back up where she started is to make sure that the number of north moves is exactly the same as the number of south moves, and the number of east moves is exactly the same as the number of west moves. And the instructions to move, we could write out the instructions for Ada 2018 in a row, and we can choose where we want the north-south and where we want the east-west to go. So let's choose some of these 2018 to be north-south moves. We need to make sure it's an even number of north-south moves because the number of north is going to be same as the number of souths. So we can choose, we've got 2018 in total, and we can choose any even number to be north-south moves. And once we've chosen where our north-south moves go, we can choose exactly half of them to be norths and all the rest are going to be souths. So I'll choose half of these to be norths. And then the rest of those are going to be souths. What I have remaining is 2018 minus two R spaces. And those are going to be our east-west moves. And I can choose exactly half of those to be east. And then all the rest will have to be wests. And that's the number of different instructions I can give to Ada. But we need to consider all of the possible values of R, and R can be anything from 0 up to 1009. And then we need to add up each one of these. Okay, so we've got an answer. That's great. We need to look at how many times 10 can go into this answer. Well, if I want to know how many times 10 goes into this sum, I need to look at every single term. And there are a lot of terms here, and each one of these terms is very big. This is going to be tricky. And actually, I think we need a different approach. So this time, let's imagine that Ada is on the Cartesian plane, and she starts and finishes at the origin. She takes her walk, possibly like this. And then what we can do is record the pairs of coordinates that represent points on this walk. She starts at the origin, she goes to point 10, and then 20. Just do a few to demonstrate. One, and this path goes back to 11, and then to 12, and so on. Okay, so we can turn the path into a sequence of coordinate pairs. So now we could just look at the x-ordinates, and we've got a string here, and every time we move from one to the next, we either go up one, or stay the same, or go down one. And that's easy enough to count. We can count the number of strings that either go up one, stay the same, or go down one. And if we look at the y-ordinates, we've got exactly the same. These either stay the same, or they go up one, and they could go down one as well. Okay, so we can count the number of strings that we can get for the x-ordinates and for the y-ordinates. That's fine, apart from the fact that only one changes at a time. So if the x-ordinate is changing, the y-ordinate must not change. So we can count the number of strings for the x's. Then when we come to count the number of strings for the y's, that's going to be dependent on what we've chosen for the x's. And we will end up with having to split it into lots of cases again, and we end up with a big sum. Another problem. Okay, let's think again. Okay, another approach. So every time we move from one of these to the next, either the x is changing or the y is changing. Well, that means that if we consider x plus y, we get a number that changes every single time. And it either goes up by one or it goes down by one. And we can count the number of possible strings here. That's doable. But there is a little bit of an issue, and that is that an x plus y number doesn't uniquely correspond to a point on the Cartesian plane. We've got two twos here, and they come from two different points. We've lost a bit of information in going from this column to this. And this is the clever bit. What we can do is also consider x minus y. And we get a new pair of numbers. So 1 minus 0 is 1. 2, 1, 0, minus 1. And in this new pair, we have got a unique correspondence between these and points on the Cartesian plane. We know we can go that way because we just add the numbers and subtract the numbers, but we can also recreate the point from these two numbers because what we've got here is a system of simultaneous equations. We know what x plus y is, we know what x minus y is, and so we can recreate the Cartesian point. The nice bit about this is that this is a string of numbers that goes up one or down one at every single point. And this is also a string of numbers that goes up one or down one at every single point. And it starts at 0 and ends at 0. There are 2018 jumps from one number to the next. And so just like we considered at the beginning, we can choose half of those jumps to be up one and the other half will have to be down one. And we know that there must be 2018, choose 1009 different strings of numbers that we can end up with for this column, and exactly the same here. And so we know that the number of different paths that start and finish at the origin must be 2018, choose 1009 squared. So we've got a new expression for the number of different paths that Ada can take. And the good thing about this expression is that it is a product and not a sum. We need to look at the highest power of 10 that will go into this. We might as well just start by looking at the highest power of 10 that will go into 2018, choose 1009. So we have this expression, and we need to look at the highest power of 5 and the highest power of 2 that will go into the prime factorization of the numerator and the denominator. That is how we will work out the highest power of 10 going in here. So let's think about how many 5s go into this. Well, every one of these numbers that is a multiple of 5 will contribute 1 5 to that number. So here we have 403 multiples of 5. But every one of these that is a multiple of 25 will contribute a second 5. And every one that is a multiple of 125 will contribute a third. And every one that is a multiple of 625 will contribute a fourth. We get a total of 502 fives in the prime factorization of the numerator. Similar calculation on the denominator gives us that we get 250 fives in this bit, and when we square it, we'll have 500 fives. That means that this expression is 5 squared times an integer that is not divisible by 5. Okay, we need to do exactly the same thing with 2s, and the calculation is really similar, but it takes a little bit longer. You need to make sure that you do that calculation, exactly the same structure as this. You end up that there are plenty of 2s, so we end up not having to worry about the 2s at all. There are lots of 2s, we don't need to worry about it. We've got 2 5s, some 2s, that means that this is 10 squared times something that 10 does not go into, which means that this is 10 to the 4 times something that 10 does not go into, and therefore our final answer is 4.